Today's Morning Mass is brought to you in part by these sponsors.
With full heart and full voice, let's join together in singing number 559, O Bless the Lord, number 559. We'll do verses 1 and 4.
Please stand.
Oh, bless the Lord, the God of our salvation, rock of strength and a refuge sure. Oh, bless the Lord, the God of every nation, over all the earth. Oh, bless the Lord, highest heavens above, bless the Lord. Glorifying His name, sun in the day, moon and stars in the night, worship and praise. Oh, bless the Lord, the God of our salvation, rock of strength and a refuge sure. Oh, bless the Lord, the God of joy to the Lord, glory and praise. Oh, bless the Lord, the God of our salvation, rock of strength and a refuge sure. Oh, bless the Lord, the God of every nation, over all.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
As we gather here today to celebrate these sacred mysteries of Christ's love, let us allow ourselves now to be quieted and stilled, and to be embraced by God's love and care.
Lord Jesus, you call us to be your disciples. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you send us out to proclaim your love to all. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you strengthen us on our journey with your presence in the Eucharist. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King. O God, almighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand, the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit, we dare to call our Father, bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the first book of Kings. Elijah went a day's journey into the desert until he came to a broom tree and sat beneath it. He prayed for death, saying, "This is enough, O Lord. Take my life, for I am no better than my father's." He lay down and fell asleep under the broom tree. But then an angel touched him and ordered him to get up and eat. Elijah looked, and there at his head was a hearth cake and a jug of water. After he ate and drank, he lay down again. But the angel of the Lord came back a second time, touched him, and ordered, "Get up and eat, else the journey will be too long for you." He got up, ate, and drank. Then, strengthened by that food, he walked 40 days and 40 nights to the mountain of God, Horeb. The word of the Lord.
See the goodness of the Lord. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. And see the goodness of the Lord. will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extol his name. I sought the Lord, and he answered me, and delivered me from all my fears. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Look to him that you may be radiant with joy, and your faces may not blush with shame, when the afflicted man called out the Lord heard, and from all his distress he saved him. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. Taste and see how good the Lord is. Blessed the man who takes refuge in him. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, with which you were sealed for the day of redemption. All bitterness, fury, anger, shouting, and reviling must be removed from you, along with all malice. And be kind to one another, compassionate, forgiving one another as God has forgiven you in Christ. So be imitators of God as beloved children, and live in love as Christ loved us and handed himself over for us as a sacrificial offering to God for a fragrant aroma. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. I am the living bread that came down from heaven, says the Lord. Whoever eats this bread will live forever.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. The Jews murmured among themselves about Jesus because he said, I am the bread that came down from heaven. And they said, is this not Jesus, the son of Joseph? Do we not know his father and mother? Then how can he say, I have come down from heaven? Jesus answered and said to them, stop murmuring among yourselves. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draw him, and I will raise him up on the last day. It is written in the prophets, they shall all be taught by God. Everyone who listens to my Father and learns from him comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father, except the one who is from God. He has seen the Father. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate the manna in the desert, but they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. Thanks. The Gospel of the Lord. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. It is getting late into the summer, and hopefully we have all had things that we were able to do again this year that we couldn't do last year. And we have one of those things coming up this weekend. That is the deacon picnic. Every year, the deacons in the Archdiocese of Omaha get together, and we have a picnic. And at that picnic, we have a chance to renew relationships, to grow in spirituality with each other, see what each other has been doing. But the very last thing and the highlight is the picnic, the food. We are blessed to have some very good cooks as deacon wives. And it's always a highlight of the event. Food is very important in the Bible as well. We see it over and over again, where food is either the main point or something that draws us to that. When we look at the first reading, we see Isaiah, Elijah, and he was pretty well done at this point. He had been through a lot. He had challenged the 400 priests of Baal, and he had won that challenge. But instead of the Israelite people turning then to God, as they said they would do, they instead put the army on him to kill him. And so he's running from the army, and he finds this broom tree, and he lays down, and he says, Lord, I am ready to die. But the Lord had other ideas for him, for he knew that the failure of this mission did not fall on Elijah, but on the king Ahab and on the Israelite people themselves. And so he sends an angel, and the angel gives him food to eat. And he eats it, he goes back to sleep, the angel comes again, and he says, you must eat, lest you will not have enough strength for the journey. So he eats, and then it says that he walked for 40 days and 40 nights to Mount Horeb, or as we know it, Mount Sinai. And so we have to realize that that was truly supernatural food that the Lord was giving Elijah. And that's the kind of food that Jesus is talking about in the gospel as well. He says, I am the bread that came down from heaven. And of course, he meets all kinds of objections from the audience that is there, skepticism. But he continues to preach in this vein. He says that unless you eat this bread, you will not have life in you. This is the bread that comes down from heaven. And we have to realize that even though Jesus at that time had not given that bread yet, it happened at the Last Supper before he gave up himself for us. He took the bread, he broke it, and he said, eat this. Remember, this is my body. So he did the same with the wine, turning it into his blood. And so there is supernatural food as well. And that supernatural food is what we need for our journey to God, our Father in heaven. And we get that food every time we go to Mass and we approach the altar, we receive the sacrament of Holy Eucharist. For that is what Jesus established at the Last Supper. And as we come forward, what we are really doing is we're saying, Lord, I am giving you everything that I am, all that I have, all that you have given me as a gift, as talents, I am giving you. And in return, we have him come to us, giving us that supernatural food. For when the Eucharistic minister stands there, holds up the host and says, the body of Christ, our response to that is, amen. What we're really saying is, I believe that that is the body of Christ, the body, blood, soul, and divinity of our Lord Jesus Christ. We understand that the tremendous gift of him coming to us is just that gift. We did nothing to earn it. But strengthened by that gift, by that food, like Elijah, we then are energized to go out and live our lives for the Lord. When we go out, we are supposed to imitate the life of Christ. That is what it means to be Christian. And there are those out there who say, well, how do you know that that's really what that is? Well, Jesus said it right here. Jesus said, I am the bread of life. The Father has sent me down here. When we recite the creed in a little while, we are going to say all of the things that we believe, and in there we're going to say we believe that Jesus Christ came down as man, died and suffered and died for us, was raised up on the last day, and gives himself continuously for us, interceding for us at the right hand of the Father. That's what we believe. That is the full truth. That is what separates the Catholic Church from every other church that is out there. We say that there are other churches who have parts of the truth. And we say that the Catholic Church has the full truth. And this is the separation point. Who do you say that I am? When we come forward and we say that amen, we are saying that, first of all, we are ready to receive you. We're giving you everything. And then we are saying, come to me, strengthen me, help me on the journey. And if we do that, remember the words of the Lord as they come back to us. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever.
The Creed. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
of all things visible and invisible.
I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets.
I believe in one holy,
Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead
and the life of the world to come. Amen.
And now as the body of Christ here on earth, as God's faithful people, we bring before our God these our prayers and needs.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our Archbishop George Lucas, Bishop Connolly, and Bishop Hanefeld, and for all the leaders of the church, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our president and for all who serve us in public office, that they will strive to work for the good of our nation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick, especially for Jim Beller, Ethan Dush, Mary Gock, Tom Jaretsky, Dennis Putani, Felicia Sweat, William Tarnick, Jim Tubbs, and Betty Zuha, that they may experience the healing power of Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially for Lois Meshek, Ron Liebig, Velma May Dreyfus-Shoup, and Clarence Zimba, that they may share in Christ's risen glory, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For more vocations to the priesthood and religious life, and that we as a parish community will encourage our young people to consider a vocation in the priesthood or religious life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for all the parishioners of St. Isidore Parish for whom this Mass is being offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our unspoken needs and intentions, let us pause and pray to the Lord in silence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Eternal God, Father and Lord of us all, you continue to be present to us even to this day under simple forms of bread and wine. Believing in your great care for us, we bring before you these our prayers and needs, asking that you grant them as you will through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As the gifts and the table are being prepared, please join in singing number 654, Loving and Forgiving, number 654.
Loving and forgiving are you, O Lord, slow to anger, rich in kindness. Loving and forgiving are you. All my being, bless the Lord, bless the holy name of God. All my being, bless the Lord. loving and forgiving are you. God forgives us all our sins, healing those who live in pain, saving us from final death. God fills us with goodness and love. Loving and forgiving are you, O Lord. Slow to anger, rich in kindness, loving and forgiving are you.
Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and George, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
As a community, we come to receive the Lord. As we come, please sing number 343, Spirit and Grace, number 343.
Holy meal.
Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. We extend our sincere sympathy to the family of Velma Dreyfirst Shoup, who died on Friday. Visitation will be here at St. Isidore on Monday from 5 until 7 p.m. with a vigil at 7 p.m. The funeral liturgy will be here in church on Tuesday at 10:30 a.m. God Teens online registration is now open, due by August 16th. See the bulletin for details. The St. Isidore's after school program could use some help. One must be 16 years old. Contact the daycare to apply. Each year, the Archbishop allows a missionary priest to visit our parish and make an appeal for assistance. Next weekend, a priest from the Diocese of Eldoret, Kenya, will be here asking for your assistance to raise money to drill a water well for the children of St. Paul's Small Home in Chesapongak Parish, an orphanage for physically and mentally disabled children who are either neglected in their homes or suffering out of extreme poverty. Envelopes will be placed in the pews for this collection next weekend. Be as generous as you can. And also, the Knights of Columbus will be selling Husker football poll books after all masses this weekend. At this time, we'd ask that the Joe and Brittany Madden family come forth to receive the vocation cross for this week. I think I'm out of slips of paper, so I must have got everything. So, let us please stand. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Let us go forth singing number 388, The Spirit Sends Us Forth, number 388.
The Spirit sends us forth to serve. We go in Jesus' name to bring glad tidings to the poor, God's favor to proclaim. We go to comfort those who mourn and set the burden free. Is dim to share a dream and help the blind to see. We go to be the hands of Christ to scatter joy like seed and hope our days to cherish life to do the loving deed. Then let us go to serve in peace, the gospel to proclaim. God's Spirit has empowered us. We go in Jesus' name.
Today's Morning Mass is brought to you in part by these sponsors.